Hi, hello, and welcome to my secret channel. First and foremost, Happy New Year to everyone. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So in today's video, we're going to learn about the poem, The Last Ride Together, written by Robert Browning. First point, it is a dramatic monologue. Second one, this poem has one speaker and silent listener. So the one speaker is none other than the poet, and the silent speaker is his lover. Narrator is a lover talking to his beloved. So narrator is a lover, we all know, and he is talking to his beloved, that is his lover. Theme, life and love, success and failure. These are the themes of this poem. Outline of this poem. The first point, it can be called as love poem, and also it is a philosophical poem. So it has 10 stanzas. Each stanza will have 11 lines in it. The principal philosophy of this poem is, life is always greater than art, and love is the best thing life can bring. One of my favorite philosophy of life. So this quote is the principal philosophy of this poem. The narrator is blaming his fate and he didn't enjoy anything from love. The narrator is blaming, he is accusing his own fate, and he is also telling that, he is expressing his inner feeling that he didn't enjoy anything from love. Out of love, he didn't enjoy anything, he is telling. He is facing failure throughout his life. One side he is blaming his fate and the other side he is praising the love. You could see in the first point, he didn't enjoy anything from love. He itself telling that he didn't enjoy anything from love. But the very next point he is telling that he is praising the love. So we could see the unpredictable nature of the poet. You give me the hope that you will be with me, but you broke the promise. So now the silent listener is listening to the poet. The silent listener is none other than the lover. The lover is listening to the poet. So he is telling that, why did you broke the promise with me? He is asking like that. And also this particular line expresses the pain of love. Asking for last ride. Finally, the poet have some guts to ask the silent listener for a ride. That is the last ride together. So, and he has the pressure that whether she will be accepting it or not. But finally, you know, she accepted. He want the whole world to end on that day. So, he want that day to be stunned like anything. He wanted that day to last forever. And that day, particular day, wanted to end because the very next day she will not be there with him. So, that day should be last forever, he is wishing that. He wanted the love to be eternal. The love between them, that should be eternal, he is wishing for that. He is happy in two ways. We can see the poet being happy in two ways. The first way is, the beloved is by his side. So, the lover is by his side. The second way is, they are enjoying the nature. On their last ride, they both are enjoying the nature. There is a mixed feeling in him. So, the poet is having so much feelings inside him. He cannot predict his own thoughts and emotions. The narrator compares his mind with that of a scrambled paper. So, here you can compare, see the comparison actually. So, the narrator, he is comparing his mind with that of a scrambled paper. A soft scrambled paper, smooth paper is flying on air. He is comparing himself with a scrambled paper. He is enjoying the particular moment, and so he is comparing like that. I am flying smoothly like a scrambled paper. He itself telling that I am flying smoothly like a scrambled paper. I have no feelings now. I am highly happy now. He is expressing his emotions like that. Did she really love me? So from the fifth stanza onwards, you could see so many questions he is raising. So the first question is, did she really love me or not? Is the first question. He is talking about his life, sticking with failure and success. So he is very much conscious about the failure and success of his own life. Am I the one who faces fail often? The questions, no, it is keep on rising in his mind. So, first question he asked, what is the question, you know? This is the second question he's asking that, am I the one who faces fail often? Only the failure occurs only to me. Why it is happening to me? Like that he is often asking. He is lost in his own thoughts. So he is having his beloved on his side, but also he is lost in his own thoughts. He keep on thinking about his past as well as the future as well as the present of him. Even though he is with his lover, he know that nothing is going to change anymore because he knows his fate. He already know his own fate. He is thinking that his fate is that he will not have any lover in the future. So he know that his fate, so that he is thinking like that. Is action and thought always the same? So right from fifth stanza, you all know that there will be so many questions asked by the poet. Okay, so this will also a question he will be asking. So he is asking that is action and thought always the same? So what is the difference between them? Do they or look-alikes or they are same or not, like that he is asking. Has anybody expressed their feelings truly to others? This is the important question. So he is asking that how many of them, how many in the universe have truly expressed their own feelings to others? Has they expressed it? Like that the poet is asking. You can ask this question to your own self and you can comment in the comment box. So he compares his life with the following categories. So he's compared his life with the stateman and soldier, poets and music composers, sculptures, and he is also telling that my life is better. Enjoy every minute of your life. This is the philosophy of the poem. Even you have to enjoy death. He's also insisting that you should enjoy each and every minute of your life, and also you should even enjoy your own death. So death is inevitable. It will, one or the other day, it will come to you. So you should enjoy your death also, he is telling. In the eternal world, I and my lover will be very much happy. He is telling that they may have their reunion in heaven. So you could see the hope of the lover, the true lover. Hope of the true lover is expressed here. The lover seems quiet from the beginning until now, but the silent speaker, the silent listener of this poem seems to be quiet right the beginning until now. The poet thinks the blissful moments of them. So the poet is keep on thinking about the lovable memories that has happened between them. He wants the last ride to be ever and ever. So the poet wants the last ride to be ever and ever. This is how the poem ends. Thank you so much for clicking this video. Thank you so much for watching. So many videos are coming ahead. So subscribe to my channel. Keep watching. Thank you.